Daryl K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium, the season opener. The Florida Atlantic Owls, winners of the Sun Belt Conference a year ago, take on the 11th-ranked team in the country, the Texas Longhorns. Welcome, everyone. Bill Lamb, Gary Reasons, glad to have you with us. And isn't it great to have another college football season underway? This place is jumping, Gary, because of the pregame activities with the retirement of Vince Young's jersey. Number 10 will be worn no more. A very emotional setting with Coach Mack Brown.
And he did it right. Tell you, just have a great legacy. The winningest quarterback in Texas history, Vince Young, and a national championship to boot. That's a great way to go out.
We'll have a chance to show you that ceremony at halftime. Make sure you stay with us for that. Now let's get to the season opener, Texas and Florida Atlantic. Speaking of great quarterbacks, Texas returns one in Colt McCoy. They may retire his number someday, the numbers he's been putting up.
Well, he's going to be the all-time leader when he's done. Colt McCoy's had a tremendous campaign. Just his junior season now, look at the numbers so far, 6 all-time. He's going to continue to move up the charts. Kind of a subpar season last year, believe it or not, just because of injury problems, but I think he'll have another breakout year this season.
Yeah, hard to say subpar when a team wins 10 ball games, but the standard is very high here at the University of Texas. If they had a big concern, it was defensively. New defensive coordinator Will Muschamp might be the answer. He comes from Auburn, had great defenses there. He's already putting his stamp here.
Well, he's an aggressive guy. He's a smart guy. He's a guy that really is going to energize, I think, this defense, and he hopes to get some success there. They had some problems a year ago, did not play the kind of defense that Mack Brown would like to play, and so he made some changes, and he thinks that Will is going to be the guy that can get that going right. Now, the biggest player for him on defense is going to be Brian Arakpo. Big defensive end, little struggle last year, had a knee injury that sidelined him for part of the season, but he's a big play weapon on the outside. He'll put pressure on quarterbacks for Will Muschamp, and if he has a good season, it could be a great season for the Longhorn defense.
And that defense will get a test tonight because this Florida Atlantic team can score. They've got an outstanding quarterback in Rusty Smith, who was the Sun Belt Player of the Year last season.
Well, Rusty Smith, he's got all the tools. He's big, Bill. He's 6'5". 230 pounds. He's got a good delivery. Kind of looks like, you know, some of the NFL quarterback bodies that are out there. He's the kind of guy that you want to lead your football team. Last year, 36 touchdowns, only 5 interceptions. So that's a pretty good ratio to work with. He's got big receivers to throw to. Going to challenge this young secondary for the Longhorns.
It's an interesting matchup, especially for a season opener. We look forward to bringing you to it on College Football Saturday. It is Texas and Florida Atlantic. Stay with us. And welcome as we are set for the kickoff here on College Football Saturday, Texas and Florida Atlantic. Bill Land as well as Gary Reasons. We'll get to our sideline man, Ahmad Brooks, in just a moment. But we're about ready to kick it off as Justin Tucker is set. There's Howard Schnellenberger, the veteran, and I do mean veteran coach, 74 years young, as he has done so much in college football, including a national title back in 83 at Miami, was at Louisville, Oklahoma for a year, and literally has built this Florida Atlantic program from the ground up.
I tell you, it's been a great job by him and Mack Brown, what he's done at this university. Unbelievable the success that Mack has had here, including a national championship.
And the kickoff.
Oh boy, out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Well, that goes after the 40-yard line. New rule this year. Ball kicked out of bounds on the kickoff.
And as a result, Florida Atlantic comes
first
up with
out of bounds. Kicking team, ball replaced at the 40-yard line. First down.
Excellent field position to start things off. As Rusty Smith, the quarterback, is a junior. He's 6'5", 230, out of Jacksonville, Florida, Sandalwood High School. And last year, what a year. Sun Belt Player of the Year as a sophomore with 32 touchdowns and just 9 interceptions.
Yeah, it's a pretty good ratio, and he's a good big guy back there. And you take a look at the offensive line, they're going to be protecting. Important pressure for the center to step up. Got a change there, and these receivers have got some big play players outside. Gent there is going to be the leading receiver for them.
Starting lineups brought to you by Time Warner, the power of you. And on the first frame, the defense is up to the challenge with a stop on the play as DeIvory Edgecombe, the redshirt senior out of Miami, is stopped 5'10", 195. Again, starting lineups as we look at the defensive side are brought to you by Time Warner, the power of you. The Longhorns are hoping for the veteran push up front. Arakpo, Miller, Houston, and Melton. The linebackers certainly solid and more with Kendall Bobineau and McElroy. And then in the secondary, there are the youngsters there. You see those two freshmen. And this one goes to the 48-yard line. And Gent, the receiver.
Bill, you talked about the freshmen. And that's the big question mark about the Longhorn defense right now is how will those young guys back there turn out? You know, they're just here, haven't been here very long. Someone, you got a redshirt freshman back there starting at safety, and also a true freshman, Blake Gordon and Earl Thomas. Those two are, getting after that there. So Will Muschamp is hoping they can play well in their debut.
Yeah, Gideon is the true freshman and Thomas the redshirt freshman. Third and three for the Owls. Play action and complete for the first down and then some. Into Texas territory. Ball is fumbled, but they're ruling it down. They're ruling it down back at the 32-yard line or out of bounds. William Rose, the receiver, they love to throw to their backs. Rose last year had 38 receptions.
Well, watch the play action fake here. Good job. Looked like they're going to run it inside, but he tosses it over the top. Play action fake. Gets outside, and then the tackle here at the edge. Ball knocked loose after he's down. Probably a good call there by the officials, but a big first down with great field position to start the ball game for the Florida Atlantic Owls.
A pickup of 22 yards and a first and 10.
Yeah, they're going to look at that.
Yep.
You know, there's a new rule in college football, Bill.
The previous play is being reviewed.
And that is, if there is a fumble at a play like that, at the end of the play, and it is immediately recovered by the defensive team, and they'll look back at it, if that ball was coming out, even though they were called down by contact, that can be turned over. That can be reviewed, and that's what they're looking at here. We're going to take another look at it to see on the sideline now. Does he maintain control all the way to the ground? It's hard to tell on that shot. It looks like the leg, one of his teammates might have come in there, and then the ball is recovered by Texas. So there's a chance that the Longhorns may get this ball back after the review. It has to be a fumble, a fumble that is already seen, and then an immediate recovery as the Longhorns recover that one.
And we're told by the replay crew as they visit with our truck folks to provide them with every shot they possibly can, they are only concerned with the fumble, not, you might have thought originally maybe he was out of bounds. That is not a concern. It's only whether he fumbled the football or not.
Yeah, from the sideline view from our side, we're looking at it the same way that the fans are at home. We don't have that reverse shot. I'm not sure that we have that. I don't know that there's enough there that I see that that's going to be called a fumble. Now, here we go. This might be a better look at it for us. We'll take a look at it. See the right arm in there and the left arm, and then his teammate comes in.
After review, the ruling on the field stands.
Yep.
First down.
Well, they didn't wait long there.
Well, that's one of the things I think as we get further into years and years of replay, everybody's better at their job.
Sure.
And the one thing they don't want to do is take forever and keep this game moving. So, Texas in a bit of trouble right from the get-go here. Alex Schnellenberger looking on as this club a first and 10 at the 31. Smith. Play action again. Good protection, deep and incomplete. Intended in the end zone, and covering the play was Blake Gideon. So he tests that young secondary.
And yeah, trying to use his all-time, his leading receiver, Cortez Gant, on the outside. Watch here come down. He's going to try to get behind the safety there. Ball just a little bit thrown. A good coverage in the secondary by the Longhorns. Gideon, the safety, coming over, like you said, Bill. And he's a true freshman. Just did the right job there playing two deep zone coverage.
Couldn't quite connect with Cortez Gant, a junior out of Chiefland, Florida. Second and 10. Smith hands it off this time. Nothing doing. Longhorns taking care of business as Chucky Brown, sophomore out of Houston from North Shore, along with McElroy, making the tackle.
And the clock, new clock this time is already running. Sets at 40 seconds when the play ends. That's actually the start of the 40-second clock. You know, one of the things that we're looking at in this game, Bill, with Florida Atlantic and Texas is actually the size difference. The Florida Atlantic Owls, their offensive linemen, are not the big monsters that you have in the Big 12 Conference. Some of them are 270, 280 across the board there. And the defensive front for Texas, very athletic and very strong inside, especially with Roy Miller and Lamar Houston.
Third and 10. Smith in a bit of trouble. Fires, got a man, and it's complete for a first down as Chris Bonner makes the reception. A junior out of Tampa, Florida, who had 37 receptions a year ago and scored three times. Ryan Palmer makes the stop for Texas.
Well, good play that time in the backfield. They allow this line to slide, protect, and take their back. William Rose to block on the outside. Watch on the right side, the left side of the screen. The fullback goes out. Good block there on Kendall, who's on the outside. Can't get to the quarterback. Then a nice delivery there by Rusty Smith outside. And Florida Atlantic, they've got some tools and weapons. They've won the championship in the Sun Belt last year, and Howard Snellenberger would like to continue things here again in 2008.
A 15-yard pickup on that play, and this time Smith now 3 of 5 after Gideon applied the big-time hit. They were not fooled on that play by the Owls.
You know, one thing that I've seen with Texas defenses over the years, doesn't matter who's out there and who's playing, is one thing that Mack Brown wants to have on his defensive team is speed. They're going to bring speed on the field, and they're going to find the right combination of players. And when you go a lateral game against the Longhorns, it typically isn't a good game plan. You've got to go right at these guys because a lateral game plan allows that speed to catch up to where you're putting the football.
And Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator, his first game here at Texas and putting his own design on. One thing about Florida Atlantic, they will try to do everything they can protect the quarterback, but you can't protect against a bad snap. And Texas has recovered the football at the 38-yard line. Sergio Kendall comes up with a fumble recovery.
Wow, the snap over his head, and wow, huge play there. Texas just rushing the quarterback there, and it's just going to be a quick snap over the top there. Matt Locks snapping the ball over Rusty Smith's head, an errant throw and trying to get out very quick. And then Kendall on the outside just getting to the football before the quarterback can.
Kendall, a junior out of Dallas, Woodrow Wilson High School, 32 tackles a year ago. Played in 8 games for the Longhorns. And now Texas gets its hands on the football for the first time at the 39-yard line. We'll give you the lineups here in a moment as Colt McCoy. And they also had John Childs in the game. Is that correct? To start things with, I believe. Starting lineups are brought to you by Time Warner, the power of you. There's Colt's numbers last year.
Yeah, they want to get that number down a little bit. 18 interceptions on the season. He needs to be a little more cautious with the football. Had some things tipped and go against him, but overall, they want to get him to be a little more efficient, get a better touchdown-interception ratio.
And the offensive line, Ulatowski, Tanner, as well as Chris Hall, who played all 5 positions last year, Dockery and Hicks.
A lot of experience with the O-line here at Texas.
McGee with the carry. Boy, showing some power there. Vondrell McGee, a sophomore out of Tyler Longview, and Michael Hancock drags him down. Have a chance to take a look at that Florida Atlantic lineup as well in just a moment. Quick start here is Florida Atlantic is knocking on the door, turned it over, and now their defensive group has to answer. Give Time Warner provides you the starting lineup, the power of you, Council Jackson Savage, and the Hancock up front. Clark, Franz Joseph, and George Allen are the linebackers. Joseph with 131 tackles to lead the league last year. Pass is complete over the middle, near a first down. Joseph and Allen covering on the play to McGee.
A very comfortable start here for Texas. Colt McCoy running this offense. Again, no huddle now. The new 40-second clock rule. A lot of teams are going to the no huddle, and they're just faking it inside. Then he's going to throw it downhill. That's your check down receiver. That's what Kendall is. Excuse me, not Kendall, but
Vondrell
McGee. Excuse me. I've never got dual numbers. They're going to mess us up tonight. But
they pass it out on the flat this time and across the 40 to the 37-yard line. As Malcolm Williams gets the reception, he is a redshirt freshman from Garland, Texas, tackled by Greg Joseph.
And they want to find out who's going to be the third receiver in this package. You got Jordan Shipley and Quan Cosby, the two stalwarts out there, but Malcolm Williams will look for him to come in and be that spark, perhaps, in the third guy.
Little option. McGee.
Great job on
busted for a first down. Texas got it moving now inside the 25, and Greg Joseph to stop there.
Well, Colt McCoy just ran this play to perfection, doing the option to the outside, and you see the numbers here of last season for Vondrell McGee, and good job by McCoy watching him going to pitch it inside, take the defender, get him to set, and then McGee around the edge. Excellent job on the option play.
Texas, a first down at the 25-yard line. And again, the handoff, and McGee, 15, and down near the 10-yard line. McGee, a first down machine. Shipley, a nice block to help open it up for him.
No doubt about it. On the outside, Jordan Shipley made this play happen because he maintained his block. Watch on the bottom of the screen here. Number 8 going to get that block right there. You're going to be able to do that run up and down the field when you can do those kinds of things. And excellent job of getting in between those blockers, and McGee having a nice start here at this ballgame.
13 yards on that pickup. Another first and 10, this time at the 12-yard line of Fort Atlantic. Cosby wide left. Shipley in the slot. And the handoff to Obanaya. Obanaya breaking tackles. Is he in? No signal. No, he was down. Chris Obanaya, the senior out of Missouri City, Texas, showing some real explosion.
Well, a lot of the work being done by Vondrell McGee to get it down the field, and Obanaya comes in. Didn't know which one of those two were going to start tonight, but Obanaya comes in. A little more experience back than McGee, but a good job of taking it inside between the tackles, and you see the knee down there, so that's why it's no touchdown, so it's going to be out on the 6-inch line.
Fans are saying, you got to be kidding me, as they take a look at the angle you're seeing here. The knee was down, according to the officials.
Now they're going to look at it.
Wait just a minute. Obanaya down there.
Yeah. It's under review.
Ask and you shall receive, and that's kind of what the UT fans are going to get. They're going to get a look-see here by the replay officials.
Obanaya last year, 21 receptions for 204 yards, 26 carries, and 66 yards. Also had a pair of touchdowns on the ground.
Now, do we have a sideline view over here? Now, the knee's down, and is it across the plane of the end zone? From that line, I'm not sure that we can call that that was in. His knee looked like it was down, and I think it's a pretty good placement by the officials.
Yeah.
Just can't tell from that angle because it's from the outside. You know, we're looking at this way, and you need to be looking 100% down the sideline here. I don't think that that is going to be there. I think the call on the field may hold.
And
yeah, this is probably going to be the best look at it here. You know, you see no football right there, and you see a knee. So I think we're going to be down on by contact as it's called on the field.
Well, does it seem a little louder in here? If it does to you at home, hang on here. We'll get the ruling. It's because of the expansion of this stadium that now seats 94,113 and has closed in that one end zone that Obanaya was going into. Fans erupted.
Ruling on the field is confirmed. First and goal.
Well, I think it's a good call, holds, and nonetheless, it's first and goal for the Longhorns inside the 1 yard line. So it looks like they're going to try to punch this thing in.
First and goal to go.
Put the jumbo package in there for the Longhorns.
Obanaya stays in the ball game. Cody Johnson is also in. As Colt McCoy trying to punch one in. There's Obanaya in motion. The handoff. Johnson. Touchdown, Texas. Cody Johnson, redshirt freshman from Waller, Texas. His first carry, a score. That's pretty good productivity.
Yeah, things were going real well for Florida Atlantic on their drive, and then they turned the ball over on an errant snap, and the Longhorns just capitalized. Good job of working the ball down the field. Running game work with Vondrell McGee. And you also get Obanaya in there, gets it at the 6-yard line, and then Johnson. Now it gets a little bit of the icing on the cake. Put that score in the end zone for Texas.
8:48 to go in the first quarter, and Texas has the lead. And coming on for the point after is Hunter Lawrence. Lawrence instead of the veteran Ryan Bailey. Bailey's had a little bit of a groin injury, and so Lawrence gets the call here tonight. He's been doing the kickoff before for his first extra point attempt, and the junior from Bernie, Texas, converts, and Texas is on top 7-0. Stay with us on College Football Saturday.
The Ivory, yeah.
And Blanchard 25. Welcome back. Texas on top 7-0, taking advantage of the turnover on a fumble recovery off a bad snap, and then eventually Cody Johnson with a TD plunging it in, and now Tucker gets ready to kick it off to the Ivory Edgecombe or Jeff Blanchard are the deep players as Justin Tucker. Texas got a number of kickers this year, and with Bailey having the injury. Tucker's now doing the kickoffs.
And that's allowed Hunter Lawrence to take over just the field goal and extra point duties. This one into the end zone, and they will down it and bring it out as it's caught there by Jeff Blanchard.
Now David Matlock getting the start tonight at center. Had a problem last snap. Snapped it over his quarterback's head, Rusty Smith. And the regular center, Nick Paris, out of the ball game. Now didn't even make the trip for Florida Atlantic. He's home with an injury. We see the errant snap here. One gets away from him. But first ball game here, Nick Paris is having to play the start at the center for Florida Atlantic.
So the Owls down 7-0. They start this drive from their 20 after the opening drive started from the 40. Put it on the ground. McElroy there lead the way for the tackle.
You'll see a lot of different formations here from Florida Atlantic. They'll go with two backs. You see a little counter block here. You have the offside guard come around. Pretty good job of making a push inside. And Matlock did a nice job there pushing out of there at the center for Florida Atlantic.
Throws the ball here. Gary Nord, the offensive coordinator at FAU. Fans, of course, of Texas remember him. He was his head coach at UTEP. This one incomplete. Tended for Lester Jean. And Nord has been with Howard Schellenberger at Louisville. He was with him at Oklahoma. And, of course, then became the head coach out at UTEP. Had some success there. And certainly knows exactly what the boss wants and has done a nice job of delivering.
Oh, he really has. And he's a good fit there for Howard Schnellenberger's program. Howard can deal with other things when you got a competent coordinator like Gary Nord, former head coach, as you talked about at UTEP, Bill, calling the shots. And he's leading this Rusty Smith attack.
Will Muschamp, the new coordinator on the defensive side for Texas, looking things over on a 3rd-and-7. Going deep and a sensational catch by Gent. Oh, my, what a play. As Brown was trying to cover on the play, Cortez Gent, who had 64 receptions in his all-conference first-team campaign a year ago, shows you why he also scored 9 touchdowns, Gary.
Good protection there and a nice, easy throw there by Rusty Smith. And then Gent just goes out for it. He runs right around the backside of Chucky Brown. Can't get him down, so good job by Florida Atlantic extending this drive.
33 yards officially on the play. And the Owls come back to the ground game as Edgecombe with the carry.
Well, a lot of UT fans are kind of surprised about Howard Schnellenberger and some of the comments that he made a few weeks prior to this ball game about talking about the Texas football team and not being as tough as they had been and not being as physical and dominant. But you see his offensive philosophy here coming out with two backs in the backfield, and they're running right at Texas's defense.
I'm sure many of the Texas fans have read that in bulletin board material. He didn't deny it when we talked to him, but he also said, what I'm trying to tell my team is that we can't beat them with talent. We'll have to be tougher and play harder in order to have a shot. But he thinks his team is capable of coming in here and winning.
Well, there's a little hat action there by the Texas defense coming around. And you know, with Howard Schnellenberger and how they've done their scheduling, Bill, you know, the past couple of seasons, they talked about having advanced training games, like games you come out to play the University of Texas. But he says no more advanced training games. We took that moniker off because they feel like they can compete now with the likes of Texas on the road and these types of ball games. That's the kind of level that he wants his program to aspire to.
Yeah, and after they won the conference championship last year, he said, we're ahead of things. We need to step it up. Well, they got a 3rd-and-3 here. They're 3 of 3, 3rd-and-6, I should say, 3 of 3 in third down conversions, and a big hit across the middle as that one was intended for Lester Jean, and Earl Thomas applied the blow. And that's typical of the matchups, Gary. Thomas 5'10", Jean is 6'3". Very athletic in the secondary, but there's some size advantage for Florida Atlantic.
They really are, and that ball was thrown high and kind of on purpose, but just a little bit higher than Rusty Smith needed to get it out there, so Florida Atlantic is going to have to punt this football.
And coming on to kick it away will be Ryan, rather Keegan Peterson. Peterson stands on his own 46-yard line. And this one sails out of the end zone. And Texas will get it back on the 20. We'll take a brief timeout on College Football Saturday. It is Texas and Florida Atlantic. Longhorns lead 7-0. Welcome back. Keegan Peterson is the punter that, as you saw, the ball went well out of the end zone. That's a mental mistake as much as a physical mistake.
Well, really, you're at the 40-yard line, plus 40-yard line. Just kick it out of bounds. Don't kick it to anybody. And the last thing you want to do is just kick it into the end zone or beyond, because you're going to give great field position to the Longhorns, which they do. Coach Schnellenberger grabbed him as he came off the sideline and had a long discussion with him about where you need to put that football.
And he's over there visiting with Mickey Grudy, another kicker, saying, this is what you need to do. Longhorns, first and 10. Pitch and catch, and it is complete to Childs, as Colt McCoy to John Childs, and this is part of the Q package, as it has been labeled by the Texas Longhorns. With Childs, obviously the backup quarterback, the mobile slash type. They've worked a lot of sets this year to get him involved. And very simple here, you want your best athletes in the field.
No doubt about it. I think that's a great philosophy to put guys out there that are explosive, and Childs is certainly one of those. Colt McCoy, nice, easy delivery. We'll see some more plays and some more different opportunities for those two in the game at the same time.
And we've also been told that there's a possibility Childs could play at the quarterback position early on. This one is complete to Cosby. Simple pass, nice run. First down right around the 40-yard line as Jermaine Council made the tackle.
Yeah, and what a career Quan Cosby has had for the University of Texas, and he's done this numerous times. Make people miss in the open field, and that's how you make explosive big plays. Greg Davis loves to have explosive plays in his offense. Quan Cosby, 10th all-time as Texas in the Texas receiving list in yardage, and Billy needs just over 1,000 yards to move up to number 3 all-time, and he could possibly get there this season.
McCoy fakes the handoff here.
Wow.
Wow, wide open, Irby.
Oh, Bebo's horn got him out around the 45-yard line. Other than that, Irby may take this right down the middle of the field. Nice rollout by Colt McCoy. And finds the new tight end, Irby, in the ball game. And right there, take a look at it. And like I said, you see the horn there? That's what got him.
Irby, you know he saw that wide open territory. He's still got 21. Great fake by McCoy to give him the time.
Really was. And then the action outside, nobody in his face, and wide open space in the middle of the field.
At the 39. And this one complete out on the edge, taken down to the 34-yard line. On the reception, Malcolm Williams again. Tarvorius Hill, a redshirt freshman, 6'1", 170, makes the stop for the Owls of Florida Atlantic.
Well, if you don't play up a little closer to these receivers of the Florida Atlantic defense, you're going to have that throw and catch opportunity for Colt McCoy all night. And he's an accurate passer, a guy who's going to deliver the ball where he needs to. He'll read the defense and take what the defense gives you. So he doesn't have to throw it down the field to make huge plays. He's got guys like Cosby who can make you miss in the open field.
You see, perfect so far tonight. McGee brought down, fumbled the football. And Florida Atlantic has recovered it. Let's see if they whistle this one dead. And
he's
down.
Yeah, he's down. We got maybe an injury there as he rolled over very quickly. And ball was not called down. It was not. It looked like he was rolled over, and looks like they're going to give it to Florida Atlantic. We'll take a look here. See the spin around, and he's on top of the defender, so he's not down. Oh gosh, he's grabbing that leg. That knee probably got held underneath him. And see the defensive lineman there just grab him, spin him around. He wasn't down. The ball came loose. That's Gervonta Jackson, the defensive lineman, putting the contact on McGee.
Jackson, a big-time hit, and then Council is the man that recovered the football. Jermaine Council, a redshirt junior out of Melbourne, Florida. And McGee off on his own power, but
UT fans want to get a replay of that and take a look at it upstairs, but Florida Atlantic getting up there really quick, getting the snap. Oh, here it comes. Couldn't get it off in time. We're going to have a review of this play.
And the replay, folks, getting a workout tonight. Now, and as they take a time on that, Gary, that running back situation is Matt Brown visits with him. For the first time in a long while, they do not have just
Texas is challenging the ruling on the field.
A feature back, a guy who, all right, we know this guy stays healthy, knock on wood. He's going to get us 1,000, 1,200-yard type. It's a little bit by committee, but you've got Obanaya, who we've seen tonight. Fozzie Whitaker, the third of this committee, if you would, he's a little dinged up. So if McGee's not able to go, then a lot of it tonight would fall on Chris Obanaya.
Yeah, Obanaya is going to get the bulk of the work if Evandrell McGee can't go. We'll take another look at this play here. A little bit different angle. And here you see Jackson. There is the knee down, and the ball comes out. I think this is going to be overturned. His left knee was down. He still had control of the football. I think they'll piece this together with different video plays and reviews. You watch the left knee. The left knee is down. He still has the football. I think that this is not going to be a fumble by Evandrell McGee, and I think Texas will get recovery of that where he put his knee down on the ground.
You know, what Gary's talking about is when they look at the replay, they take a look at every angle and they learn different things from each angle and sometimes are able to piece that together. So we'll see what happens.
Well, the Longhorn defense is out there right now, and also the Longhorn offense. They don't know which way to go, so
let's prepare.
Okay, now here's one more look at it. Now the left knee is going to be down. There it is, down on the ground, and he's still got the football. So I'd be pretty surprised if this was not overturned. Mack Brown throwing the challenge flag on this play, trying to keep the football for his offense.
Texas got their score tonight after a turnover by Florida Atlantic. And Florida Atlantic has not shown the ability to slow them down. This turnover could be kind of vital to their situation, even though we're early on with 4:40 to go here in the first quarter.
Well, one turnover early in the ball game, snapped over the head of the center, above the quarterback by Florida Atlantic. Set up Texas for their first drive and score of the night. And now as they're driving to take it in again, Texas, they don't want to give that opportunity away also.
After review, the runner's knee was down on the ground prior to the ball. He lost. Therefore, first down, Texas. Texas will not lose a timeout due to the successful challenge.
And again, Bill, one of these plays where replay showed it. They got it right. They turned it the right way. So Texas football here, but Mack Brown has to throw the challenge flag. It wasn't something that was quick enough, but we had to get two or three angles from our truck to the replay booth to get the correct one there. But it all worked out in the end.
That's what is important. And the Longhorns will have possession at the 29-yard line.
More importantly, how is Evandrell McGee?
Yeah. They're making sure now they got the ball placed properly. It's a first and 10 after that 5-yard gain at the 29-yard line. So Obanaya in the backfield here with Colt McCoy. Obanaya takes it forward, picks up nice gain, gets it a couple down to the 27, maybe the 26-yard line.
Now here comes McGee back in the ballgame. He seems to be okay. That's good news there as Obanaya comes out. Just a little tweak there for Evandrell. Kind of scared me here because I don't want him to get hurt early in the season or any player to get hurt. Need to not allow him to continue this football team.
He run of the ball carrying on that opening drive. Second and 8 from the 27. McCoy showing his running ability. At the 20, watch out. He's got a blocker or two. Tugs it all the way down inside the 5-yard line. Colt McCoy, who last year ran for 492 yards, and what was an offensive coordinator, Greg Davis, said, if Vince Young hadn't played here, people think, what an unbelievable runner.
And he really is a very good athlete, an excellent runner, does a good job of making people miss, fights through tackles, and does a good job of continuing down the field, most importantly. And that's a nice run on the outside by Colt McCoy, who did a good job faking it, read it inside, and took it around the edge.
25 yards on the pickup, and they're knocking on the door again. First and goal from the 2-yard line. Average of 9.3 yards per play. McCoy in trouble. Scrambles loose. Got a man. Complete touchdown, Obanaya. McCoy gets his first TD pass of the year. Obanaya gets the Longhorns' second score of the first game, and it's Texas 13-0.
Well, what choice do you want to make here? A little counter action. You got your fullback coming out, Obanaya. Easy throw and catch by Colt McCoy on the outside. He could have run that in as well.
8 plays, 80 yards, 326 is all it took with a little timeout for the replay to be taking place. And now Hunter Lawrence for the point after. And it is good. 14-0. Texas on top over Florida Atlantic. We have 3:15 to go in this first quarter of the season opener. Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. We'll be right back with more College Football Saturday. There it is, the new look of Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium with that new end zone expansion and capacity now over 94,000 seats. But they actually will count all the workers, everybody here, and we'll get a count on that officially later. They expect it to be around 97, 98,000. Wow. And Matt Brown said he liked Ohio State's horseshoe look, and that was one of the things that was presented in the years here as they've tried to develop this, and it does have a little similar look to it.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And then you take on the other end zone, you got this monster video board.
Godzillatron.
It is a tremendous sight here in Texas.
Kickoff in the end zone, and they're going to bring it out this time as Edgeco, the 10, the 15. Wrong decision. He is brought down near the 18-yard line. And about Brooks, our sideline man, he's got a special guest. Kevin Durant is in the house.
Indeed I do. Vince Young is being honored today for one of the better athletes ever to play on the football field here at the University of Texas. But moving to the hardwood, I'm joined now by the NBA Rookie of the Year, Kevin Durant. Kevin, it's good to see you back in Austin, my friend. What brings you back?
You know, I just want to come and show the support to Vince and, you know, along with the rest of the Longhorns, come back and enjoy the game.
Well, I know you had a wonderful first season, NBA Rookie of the Year, nearly almost made that Olympic team. What was it like playing with those guys and in your first season, man? How do you feel like you progressed?
You know, everything's a learning experience for me, and I just try to take everything in stride, always work hard, but it was a fun season. It was a long season as well, but, you know, it was a fun season, you know, playing alongside P.J. Carlissimo, a great coach and a legendary coach, so, you know, I just got to get better, man.
Now, your relationship with Vince, you all, I noticed you all joking and being jovial over here on the sideline. How is your relationship with Vince? How do y'all know? How'd y'all meet? What's the deal with you two guys?
You know, I met Vince after my freshman year. You know, he came back and, you know, I got to talk to him a little bit. And, you know, he's a great guy to be around, man. And even though he's an NFL star, he never gets big head. He's always humble. So that's a great guy I like to be around. And our relationship has grown, you know, since we're both in professional sports and, you know, and we both went to Texas. So, you know, he's a great guy.
In fact, we appreciate your time, Kevin. Always good. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, I said, one of the best on the hardwood here at the University of Texas.
Now, Ahmad, we got to have one more question. What's the name? The name of the new team.
The name of the team? What team?
Oklahoma City.
The Oklahoma City. What about Oklahoma, man?
I think the name come out next week, so I know by next week.
Party line.
I'm just like you guys. I'm waiting for the name.
Tell the truth, Kevin.
And on top
know.
Of that, you obviously are here, and you were talking about the great things with Vince. Those are also things that you have qualities as well. How soon in the future, if any, will your name and your number be hanging from the rafters and the drum?
We're going to try to get this done, you know, this year. You know, hopefully my schedule conflicts with their schedule, and I come down here for a game, and this year we're going to get it done.
Guys, back to you.
All right, thank you very much. And good
I think he knows more than he's saying. I really do.
Well, that is the worst-kept secret in the world of sports, Oklahoma City Thunder in the NBA.
No, that's not it, Bill. They haven't officially announced that.
No, okay. All right, let's get back to some football here where Florida Atlantic had a completion to Bonner a couple plays ago, and Smith is now 5 of 11 for 89 yards, and it's now a 3rd and 10 from the 30-yard line. Complete across the middle, and then breaking a tackle, and more. Grant, still going, inside the 10-yard line.
Well, more important, he was wide open. It was a missed tackle in the middle field by Earl Thomas. Coming up on Grant, trying to make a tackle. And this is just going back against the grain, and you'll see Thomas come into the picture here and just kind of whiff on him. Just got to wrap up. You got to get your head in front and hold on. You're the last person, the secondary. You've got to make that play, and good job of Grant trying to get down the field. And you got a helper in blocking out there, his other speedy receiver in Cortez Gant.
They had a five-wide scenario there that time, and certainly it worked because Jamari Grant, a junior out of Jacksonville, Florida, goes 62 yards. And now it's Florida Atlantic on a first and goal at the 8-yard line of Texas. They're going to throw it up for grabs here, and it's nearly taken by Texas as they're going to Gent.
You know, everyone knows that Texas had some problems in the secondary a year ago, did not have the success that they like. in the bottom tier. I'm going to be polite here. In the bottom tier of pass coverage units in the country in college football. They need to make an improvement this year, but this team, Florida Atlantic, they're capable of throwing the ball down the field with Rusty Smith. He's a poised quarterback. He's got skilled receivers to throw to. This is going to be a good challenge for this young Longhorn secondary tonight.
Texas gave up 277 yards a game in the air last year. That was 109 in the country.
I was being nice, Bill.
Just giving the facts, because they've said, all right, we got to fix that. Second and goal. Smith tipped in the end zone, and it is picked off. Interception, Ryan Palmer. The senior out of Arlington Bowie in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex comes up with a turnover and saves the day.
Well, the senior cornerback back there does his job, but I don't think Rusty Smith has a very good idea of where he's thrown to. If you just kind of look at colors, you can hold it right there. You can see there's six orange jerseys in the secondary and only one white jersey. Look at all that orange color, and guess who comes down with it? Not a very good decision, I think, by Rusty Smith to throw that football, to try to squeeze it through that window. The throw wasn't there, but a big play by Palmer coming up with a tip pass.
Texas comes back with their Q package, as we mentioned, and that means John Chiles. Actually, Chiles would be the quarterback. They do have a scenario where Colt McCoy is in the game and not at quarterback. Chiles himself in trouble here, and there'll be a loss on the play as they smother in near the 10-yard line. Forward progress stopped near the 15 as Joseph and Hancock are there.
I'm going to leave Chiles in here at the quarterback spot. Going to let him play his way out of this, I think. It's going to be one of those series where they want to see how he operates as a quarterback, not as a slash position or receiver outside.
Second and 15 after the loss of five for Chiles and crew. They come after him again here. He finds McGee. McGee ripped away from one tackle attempt. Flag is thrown late as he was stopped near the 18, and Savage made the tackle, Josh Savage.
That was good recognition by George Allen, the linebacker for Florida Atlantic, number 50. Initially diagnosed that play and almost had the tackle. Got to let him slip through. We got a Florida Atlantic player down and got a penalty as well. And there's a good look at George Allen, the senior, 6'1", 240-pounder. He moved from his strong linebacker spot last season to the weak linebacker spot and going to play a little bit more outside.
There is no foul on the play. Timeout for the injured player. Third down.
101 to go here before the end of the first quarter. And had a number of stoppages already tonight, some because of replay.
See the Longhorn
injury.
Yeah, the Longhorns out front. There's George Allen getting outside there, doing a good job of diagnosing play. Just got to make that tackle. Then his teammates come in and continue to play on McGee, and we're tending to the Florida Atlantic player down on the field.
Council.
And the defensive end, big Jermaine Council, the redshirt junior.
13 games a year ago and got the start today after an injury to Robert St. Clair. And Council out of Melbourne, Florida. And they help him up. And
good fans here in Texas applauding the young man getting up. And boy, they love football here in Texas, Bill. They love the atmosphere. It's great when you come to Austin. People outside of the stadium just doing it up right with the tailgates and everything going on.
Great to get the college football season underway. And certainly this year, Texas, even though going 10-3 a year ago, Oklahoma, the overwhelming pick in the south, Missouri up in the north. So if Texas can ever be under the radar, this is certainly the season where they got a chance to develop, and then who knows what happens. Chiles, incomplete. And the play of John Chiles is one of those things that's going to have to come about, and that's what you use your non-conference games to do, that you're going to get a chance to put him in when real bullets are flying.
Well, he's learning, and you see he's going over the sidelines, talking to a former quarterback here, Major Applewhite, who's now on the staff working with Greg Davis in the offense. And need that guy who's got experience out there to help coach those quarterbacks along. You know, Colt McCoy, who knows this offense. And new coach, and Applewhite, who came back to Texas.
Trevor Gerland is on for the punting. Gerland averaged 37 yards a kick last year, and this one not fair caught and finally stopped about the 38-yard line. And that's where Florida Atlantic will take over as Polo on the punt return. Well, we're talking about flying under the radar. Mac Brown offered a comment about that approach to Texas this year.
None of that's really important except for all of the jibber jabber in the summer. The only thing that's important is how you finish, and where you start really doesn't matter.
Mac Brown in his 11th year here at the University of Texas. He says, there's no pressure here. Fans just want you to win all the games.
That's all.
That's only
all.
One a week. As long as you do that, everybody's happy.
Suit up, win. That's all they want.
Play action for Rusty Smith.
Out of bounds.
Acrobatic catch, but no, you're right. As that again was the 87, Jamari Grant.
Big, tall receiver. You got a good frame there. 6'5", 210-pounder. I could see why that Smith likes to throw the ball out there to him. And coming across the field well, but just a little bit late getting there. In coverage, you have Blake Gideon, the freshman, again.
Matt gave him a little help on the call as well, just in case the officials needed it. Florida Atlantic running the ball, they're 6 for minus 16. So it has been solely...